A very good morning, my dear students of class 8. Today, in reproduction of plants, this is the last part, part 5, and the topic is sexual reproduction in plants. Under this heading, we'll be learning the characteristics of insect, wind, and water pollinated flowers, fertilization. So, very quickly, we'll be doing the recap. In the previous video, we learned that pollen grains are transferred from anther to the stigma through various agents of pollination. And what are these agents? Insects, wind, and water. So if you include animals also, there are four agents. Otherwise, you can say there are three agents: insects and animals, wind and water. So one by one we'll be studying about the characteristics of these flowers. The first one, which is insect pollinated. What are the characteristics of this type of flowers? They are usually large with colored petals to attract the insects. So their petals are very beautiful, large, attractive, so that the insects are attracted for pollination. These are scented also, and since they are scented, what happens? Because of their fragrance, the insects locate these flowers by smell. They contain nectar, which is the food for insects. So insects come in search of nectar. Nectar is sweet fluid, and then they consume it as food. In order to do that, they do the process of pollination. These produces sticky pollen grains. So in these flowers, you'll find the pollen grains are sticky. And what happens? Whenever the insects visit this flower to take the nectar, these pollen grains, which are sticky, they may stick to the body parts of these insects, and when they visit another flower, they may drop it or rub it off. Okay, so pollination takes place. The next one is characteristics of wind pollinated flowers. So since here insects are not involved, so the flowers are usually very small and they are of dull colors. They are not attractive. They generally have long anthers protruding out, that means coming out, sticking out of the flower, so that pollen grains may get blown off easily. Anthers are long and they are protruding outside, so with the wind the pollen grains are blown off. Since all the pollen grains, they don't fall on the stigma, they might fall anywhere, and that is why we call it is a wasteful process. So many of the pollen grains are wasted, and that is why large quantity of pollen grains are produced by these flowers. And the last one, the pollen grains are light. Why they are light? So that they can easily carried away by the wind. And the last one here, characteristics of water pollinated flowers. These flowers are also very small and light, so that they can easily float on water. In water pollinated flowers, the male and female flowers are born on different plants, separate plants. Here also many are wasted, many pollen grains are wasted, so they are produced in large numbers. The male flowers, after maturation, get detached from the plant and float above the water surface, and then they happen to come in contact with the female flowers and the pollination takes place. Then comes fertilization. The definition for fertilization is the fusion, union of male and female reproductive cells or gametes to produce a zygote. So fertilization is the process in which male and female gametes, they combine, they fuse together and produce a zygote. See how fertilization takes place. After pollination, that means the pollen grains are already transferred from the anther to the stigma. Once the pollen grain reaches the stigma, here you can see this is the stigma, the upper part of the female reproductive part. Okay, this is stigma, style, and then ovary. So here these red ones are the pollen grains which have come from the anther. So they have come to the stigma. Now these pollen grains which fall here, they absorb moisture from stigma surface and begins to grow a tube. You can see this yellow ones, these are the tubes which enters into the stigma and travel downwards. So now you can see it is moving downwards towards the ovary through the style. So it comes here and ultimately it penetrates the ovary. The tube containing pollen grain is called pollen tube. Now you can see the pollen tube. So this yellow one is the pollen tube. Inside this we have got the pollen grains which goes from the stigma to style and ultimately it reaches the ovary. Now here in this picture it is very clear. Here you have got the pollen grains which is landed on the stigma. This is the pollen tube, this is style, this is the ovary, and this is ovule. Okay, the pollen tube enters the ovary and penetrates into the ovule. Now this goes down and then it penetrates, it goes in, okay, in the ovule. In the ovule, pollen tube releases the male reproductive cells or male gametes. So here, just for your convenience, I have made it red to show the male gamete, and this is the female gamete or egg, male and female gametes or reproductive cells. The male gamete fuses with, combines with female gamete present in the ovum of the ovule. Now union of this, the combination of these two, male and female gametes, it results in the formation of zygote. That means zygote is produced. Now this zygote develops into a seed and the ovary develops into a fruit. The ovule containing the fertilized cells develop into a seed. So always remember, it is the ovule which turns into a seed, and the covering of the ovule, it becomes the seed coat, and the ovary containing the seed develops into a fruit. So ovule is the seed, covering of the ovule is seed coat, and the ovary changes into the, develops into a fruit. The ovary remains attached to the stalk, as in the beginning the flower is attached to the stalk, same way ovary remains attached to the stalk or the flower and grows into a fruit. The ovule which was inside the ovary, it develops into the seed or seeds. But the other parts like sepals and petals, they fall off after the fertilization. So petals and sepals are not there, only ovule and ovary is there. Ovule turned into seed and ovary is developed into a fruit. Now here we have got a flow chart to show how fertilization takes place. The first process is pollination, that means transfer of pollen grains from the anther to stigma. After the pollination, the pollen grain containing the male gametes, it lands on the stigma, I have shown you. Germination, upon observing the moisture, the pollen grains begins to grow a pollen tube which starts lengthening in the direction of ovule towards the egg cell. So it moves downwards. Then comes the third process, that is penetration of the ovule. The pollen tube penetrates the female gametophyte and enters into the ovule. And here it is, there's a term called double fertilization. So this you'll be learning in the higher classes. But in short, what happens is this pollen tube which penetrates the ovary goes into the ovule. Here two germ cells are carried in the pollen tube. They fertilize the egg nucleus and polar nuclei, and two things are formed, that is zygote and endosperm. That is why we call it double fertilization. So for you, what is important to know, that here the female reproductive cell or gamete, female gamete or male gamete, they fuse together, combine together and produce zygote, that is fertilization. Okay, about double fertilization you'll be studying in the higher classes. The last topic here is artificial pollination. Pollination, all of us, we know the transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma, but that is natural pollination. Artificial pollination means human activity is involved. When the humans are involved in transferring the pollen from anther to stigma, it is called artificial pollination. But this is not a new practice. In the olden days also, the people in the ancient times, they used to sprinkle the male flowers of palms on female flowers. Okay, that's how they do the artificial pollination. But in modern times, artificial pollination is practiced by the plant breeders. What they do, if they want to have a new and developed variety, a better variety, so what they do? They remove the anther in young flowers. So suppose if there is a very healthy flower, so in the beginning only they remove the anther, the male part they remove, and cover such flowers by plastic bags. So now these flowers are covered with plastic bags, and inside the plastic bags, only the, in the flower, only the female part is there, female reproductive part is there. Now once they are fully matured, what they do, such flowers are then pollinated with pollens from plants of the desired variety. So whichever variety is good, okay, giving better flowers or fruit, so that type of variety they take and pollinate them. So this is called artificial pollination. Plant breeders, they do it to get new and better variety of plants. Okay, so with this we have come to the end of this chapter. Let's stay home, let's stay safe, okay, and have a good day.